Talent Vision Football Club were made to sweat for 3 points when they narrowly edged visitors Kasmina following a tightly contested duel at the Bridge Saturday the 6th of September. With the defeat, Kasmina sink deeper towards the relegation zone, but their chairman Eric Chipangura remained optimistic of his team's survival in the Southern Region Division 1 League.
We're optimistic we're going to maintain our status in the Division 1, which I'll bet my last cent we're going to achieve.
Talent Vision attacked from the onset, and no sooner had the match begun than hitman Gray Kufandada showed intent first with a header that forced Kasmine keeper Ishmael Mudimba into a server before his shot from the edge of the box was collected clean. Gray was getting closer with each opportunity that Talent Vision were carving, and a sweet half-volley narrowly missed target after connecting a cross from the right. Next to try his luck at the Kasmine goal was talented youngster Njabulo Ngwenya, after a great turn in midfield allowed him space to attempt a long-range shot that drifted wide of Ishmael Mudimba's goal. Mudimba was a busy man as Kasmine absorbed all that was being thrown at them. He had to remain alert to thwart yet another Gray attempt. Against the run of play, Kasmine Charles Murusha has no excuse for not hitting the target after a free header off a corner. Kasmine had settled and homekeeper London Zulu would soon be called to make a reflex save to deny Never Dube's close range attempt. Action swung back to the Kasmine goal, and diminutive Brian Moser would lose his balance as he attempted to break deadlock from the edge of the box. Kasmine were now seeing more of the action in the home box, and Dennis Turini would shake the side netting as the visitors again attempted to use set pieces to penetrate the home defense. A few moments later, play was then brought to a halt when far side assistant Sally Spanda reported a verbal abuse by Kasmine coach Robert Kamanga. The Kasmine mentor did not take lightly to his expulsion, and it had to take the persuasion of team manager Ekem Makonese to eject him off the technical area. As Kamanga departed, he appeared to have second thoughts, returning for yet another verbal tirade at the match official, but as is the usual case in football, no amount of protest compels a reversal of official decisions. The referee's command ruled supreme, and Kamanga eventually bellowed instructions from the perimeter fence. Play resumed with Greg Fandada stretching at the Kasmine defense to elastic limits with his pace, but keeper Mudiba was quick off the line, and with that attempt, the teams went to halftime at a nil all stalemate. In the second half, Talent Vision appeared to have gone a gear up, and exciting Njabulo Ngwenya was again impressive with his dribbling skills, only to lack power in finishing. Gray Kufandada surely should have broken at the deadlock after Brian Musa's ball across the face of goal, but Gray unbelievably scooped to the heavens. It will take a Felix Moyo's great interception of a crosser from the right to prevent connection with prowling Never Dube. Talent Vision goalkeeper London Zulu would then be summoned to produce a save from the top shelf as he went airborne to thwart what looked a certain goal from Never Dube's header. Without doubt, Zulu was a busier man in the second half. The masterstroke was the introduction of super substitute Adonis Nyoni for veteran Heritani Masuku. No sooner had Nyoni come on than he had a diving header cleared off the line as Adonis announced his arrival in spectacular fashion. Talent Vision were now in travelling gear. It appeared only a matter of time before they cracked a nut, and on a great day for Kufandada, the usually dependable striker would soon balloon his shot off target as he attempted a first-time strike. Adonis then struck with chilling accuracy following another piece of good work by the irrepressible Brian Musa to spot Adonis, who threaded an unstoppable shot to separate the two teams with his goal. Kasmine did not give up the fight. They did cause some anxious moments for Talent Vision, but end of it all, it was a case of too little too late as Talent Vision walked away with 3 points. After the match, Talent Vision coach Mkubali Masuku confirmed that Kasmine had been a difficult lot.
It wasn't an easy game, it was a very tough game, but at least we managed to creep a point.
Masuku revealed that it was their training that brought the defining moment of the match.
In terms of substitution, Adonis has been doing well at training, and he scored so many goals at training this week. So I think giving him a chance, it was a turning point for us.
Kasmine team manager Ekem Makonese, despite the loss, was satisfied with their performance.
Played very well, Makati. We have to work on the finishing.
Club chairman Eric Chipangura read from the same page as his team manager.
Typical gritty away performance. We went down to an unfortunate goal, maybe opportunistic, shall I call it. But I think considering we're playing away from home, it was quite a fair performance.
Long-serving veteran defender Wilfred Nzondo said the match was now behind them and they were already looking to their next fixture.
Since we said the next match, we are the teammate that is one who designs and Jan. Jamoba, Sibu relegation zone. We've seen some mistakes here too. Sibu, I want to survive the relegation.
with third and fourth place the ZPZ Wange and Slovia Nyathela inactive at the weekend. Television shoot up from fifth to fourth on the log, and will they stick on the same spot or even ascend further as we claw to an exciting climax of the southern region? Time will tell, but for now, Talent Vision look well on track for their targets. Tandazani Zimbabwe Television Sport Media, The Bridge, Bulawayo.